Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh dan salam sejahtera. Okay, so today we continue with our lesson with chapter 2, which is differentiation. Okay, so kita ada introduction, definition, technique dia, and then derivative of trigonometric, exponential and logarithmic function, dan ada lagi lah nanti ni. Okay, so nanti kita yang selebihnya tu kita akan sambung lain hari. Okay. Okay, so introduction to derivative. Okay, so differentiation ni lah. Okay, so derivative actually is about finding slope. Okay, so slope of what? Slope of the tangent line. Okay, so here we have a graph. Okay, so kita ada curve. Okay, so derivative ni berkaitan slope gradient of the tangent to the curve. Okay, so nanti dia akan ada tangent. Dekat setiap point ni ada tangent. Tangent line. So what is tangent line? So tangent line actually is the line which is touch at only one point. Ya, so macam ni, kita ada garisan hijau ni, dia touch pada dua point. So kalau ada dua point ni, maksudnya dia bukan tangent line. So this one we call it as secant line. Okay, so secant line, dia touch dekat dua point A and B. Okay, so slope untuk derivative ni, so derivative ni is the slope of tangent line. So tangent line ni adalah garisan yang menyentuh hanya satu titik sahaja. Contoh kalau kat sini, titik ni, so garisan dia ada dekat sini. So dia akan sentuh pada satu titik sahaja. Okay, so kalau dekat atas ni, so tangent line dia macam ni lah. Okay, so dia sentuh pada satu titik sahaja. Okay, itu adalah tangent line. So derivative is finding slope of the tangent line to the curve. Okay, okay, so before that, okay, so kita pergi ke basic dulu. Okay, so we have a line, secant line, which is touch to A and B. Okay, so let's say here is X. Here the point here is x plus h. Okay, so maksudnya jarak antara point A dengan B ni dia tak jauh sangat. Okay, so let's say here is 2, so here maybe 2.01, so h dia adalah 0.1 lah. Okay, so jarak dia ni sikit je. Okay, so this one h. Okay, okay, so next, if here x, so the value here is fx. Okay, so nilai dia x. Contoh kalau f x sama dengan 2. Sama dengan 2 pula, sama dengan x kuasa 2. So kalau korang cari f 2, so dia akan jadi 2 kuasa 2. Betul? Okay, so maksudnya ni, sini ni adalah nilai fx. So if this point is x, so here the value here is fx. Okay, so if the value here is x plus h, so therefore the value here is f x plus h. Okay, so therefore the point this one is x f x, and point here is x plus h and f x plus h. Okay, dia agak susah lah bagi korang untuk faham sebab dia pakai simbol-simbol je. Okay, so sebab dia secara umum. Okay, penerangan ni secara umum. So kalau pakai nombor, contoh sini 2. So if this one is 2, so this one is f2. So if here is 2.01, so here is f 2.01. Okay, so kalau x plus h ni maksud dia, contoh dia 2 plus 0.1. Okay, so dia macam ni lah. So kalau sini F2, sini 2 tambah 0.1, sebab H dia 0.1. So ni untuk contoh nombor tu lah. Okay, so tapi dia tak, dan secara umum, penerangan secara umum dia tak ada nombor, dia pakai simbol-simbol sahaja. Okay, okay, so here I already write down again. So this point is point B, which is x plus h, fx plus h, and this point is x and here is fx. Okay, so maksudnya kat sini ni adalah x1, y1. Sini adalah x2, y2. Okay, so formula untuk cari gradient of a line. Okay, so kecurunan untuk line ni, formula dia adalah okay, so formula dia adalah y1 tolak y2 bahagi x1 tolak x2. Okay, so in term of this symbol yang the x plus h, f x plus h ni, okay, so we have the slope of the secant line which is f x plus h. Okay, so sini tambah tolak pula, okay, f x plus h minus f x over x plus h minus x. Okay, so sini y1 minus y2. Okay, so y1 minus y2, where y1 is fx plus h and y2 is fx, divide by x1 minus x2. So where x1 is x plus h and x2 is x. Okay, so x2 adalah x. And then simplify. So we have x plus h minus f hack fx divided by h. So bahagi h kerana x tolak x kosong. Okay, so ni kita dah ada formula slope of the secant line. Okay, so itu untuk secant line. Okay, so untuk derivative ni, tadi saya kata apa? Dia adalah slope of the tangent line. Okay, so if this line, this point moving. Okay, so bila point bergerak ke sini, pergi ke sini, pergi ke sini, pergi ke sini. Okay, so apa yang korang boleh perhatikan kat sini? Okay, so bila garisan ni gerak ke bawah, so apa yang akan jadi? H ni, so ni tadi H kan, jarak dia adalah H, the distance this one is H. Okay, so the distance H this one will become smaller. Dia akan mengecil. So bila dekat sini, H dia dah tinggal segini. Okay, so if the this point moving here toward here, okay, so the H become more smaller. Okay, so H dia akan kecil. So H dia akan menghampiri kosong. Sampailah point ni, sampai dekat point A. Okay, so maksudnya point yang bergerak ni sampailah berhenti dekat A. So bila berhenti dekat A, so bermaksud garisan tu akan sentuh pada satu titik sahaja dan dia akan jadi tangent line. So bila dah jadi tangent line, okay, so bila H ni, when H approaching to zero, so bila H menghampiri ke kosong, so line yang warna hijau ni akan bersentuh pada satu titik sahaja dan dia akan menjadi tangent. Okay, so bermaksud kat situ gradient ni, formula this one, formula gradient tu, okay, so when h approaches to zero, so this formula will become derivative. So will become the derivative of fx. Okay, so when h approaches to zero, so this formula will become the derivative of fx. Okay, so therefore from this concept, okay, so yang ni tadi, so daripada B ni, point B, dia pergi ke sini. Okay, so point B ni dia pergi sini, pergi sini, dia akan menghampiri ke point A. Sampailah dia jadi tangent line yang hitam. Okay, so yang hitam full line ni lah. Okay, yang bukan dash dash. So yang dash dash tu menunjukkan garisan hijau tu bergerak-bergerak menjadi tangent line. Okay, so bila jadi tangent line, so kita akan dapat derivatif lah. Okay, so we have this one. Okay, so slope of the tangent line is given by formula of gradient tadi, when h approaches to zero. Okay, so therefore we have limit this formula as h approaches to zero. Okay, so therefore the definition of derivative. Okay, so the derivative of a function fx with respect to x is defined as f prime x equal to limit h approaches to 0 f x plus h minus f x over h. Okay. And this definition also sometimes we call the principle of the differentiation. Okay. Okay, so untuk definition ni, so kita akan gunakan sekiranya soalan minta. Okay, so kalau soalan minta, kita pakai formula ni. Okay, so kalau soalan tak minta, so nanti kita akan pakai yang lain lah, yang lagi mudah lah. Okay. Okay, so symbol for derivative, if the function is fx, so the derivative is f prime x. If the function is y, so the derivative is y prime or dy over dx. Okay, so f prime x is read as f prime of x, and dy over dx is read as derivative of y with respect to x. Okay, so d derivative of y respect with x. Okay. Okay, so dy dx tu kadang ditulis macam ni, d over dx y. Okay, so bermaksud derivative of y respect to x. Okay, so derivative of y respect to x. Okay. Okay, so here is the example. Okay, so given fx equal to 2x square minus x plus 2. So find f prime x using the definition of derivative. Okay, so ni soalan minta. Okay, so definition of derivative. So dia minta gunakan definition of derivative. Okay, so the definition of derivative, f prime x is given by limit h approaches to 0 f x plus h minus f x over h. Okay, so which is equal to limit h approaches to 0, so fx plus h. So bermaksud kat sini, sini x. So sekarang dalam ni ditukar x plus h. So bermaksud semua x ni kita akan tukar kepada x plus h. So dia jadilah 2 x plus h power of 2 minus so minus x plus h plus 2. Okay, so ni yang pertama tadi, fx plus h. So semua x tukar dengan x tambah h. Okay, semua x tukar dengan x tambah h. And then minus with fx. So minus dengan fx. 2x square minus x plus 2. Okay. Setiap kali gantikan, letak kurungan. Macam yang tadi, yang pertama tadi. Okay, so saya buat fx plus h. So ni simbol. So yang ni saya gantikan dengan yang ni. Okay, so gantikan dengan yang dalam ni. Yang mana dalam ni, saya gantikan x dengan x tambah h. Okay, so bila ganti ni, sini bracket. Okay, so bila ganti x ni dengan x tambah h, letak bracket. Okay, so bila gantikan x ni dengan x tambah h, letak bracket. Nah, sama juga. Ni fx, saya gantikan dengan fungsi yang atas ni. Okay, so selepas tu saya letak bracket. Okay, and then divide by h. So h tak ganti apa, tak ganti apa-apa. So h lah. Okay, okay, so kenapa letak bracket? Sebabnya kita nak elak benda-benda macam ni lah. Kalau tak letak bracket, nanti korang akan buat tolak 2x kuasa 2. Okay, tapi yang sebenarnya tolak ni kena kembang masuk dalam. Sebab atas ni definisi dia, tolak ni tolak fx. Semua fx ni kita kena tolak. So maksudnya tolak ni untuk semua ni sekali. Okay, so berbalik pada kita punya yang ni tadi. So how to calculate? So it is equal to limit h approaches to 0. Okay, so first expand this power of 2. So we have 2x square plus 2xh plus h square, and then expand this negative. Okay, so this negative expand. So we have minus x minus h plus 2. Then put in bracket, because bracket yang besar ni kita tak selesaikan lagi. Okay, so h square ni tadi ada lagi satu bracket. Okay, so sebab sini bracket, sebab sini bracket. And then minus 2x square minus x plus 2 over h. Okay, so it is equal to limit h approaches to 0. Okay, so and then expand this 2. So we have 2x square plus 4xh plus 2h square. And then minus x minus h plus 2. Close bracket. And then minus 2x square minus x plus 2 over h. So it is equal to limit h approaches to 0. Okay, and then open this bracket. Okay, so tak ada apa-apa yang kita boleh buat. So the only we have here is 2x square plus 4xh plus h square minus x minus h plus 2. And then expand this negative. So minus 2x square plus x minus 2 over h. And then simplify. So we have 2x square. Here also minus 2x square. So become 0. Okay, so habis. And then for xh, ada for xh. Ada lagi tak xh? Tak ada. So tak ada. So therefore we have 4xh. Okay. And then, okay, so ni dah. Kita dah buat. Kita dah tulis. Then 2h square. Ada h square? Tak ada. Okay, so plus 2h square. Okay, it's already write down. Okay. And then minus x plus x. Okay, so 0. And then minus h. Minus h. And then plus 2 minus 2. Become 0. Divide by h. Okay. Seterusnya. Okay, so yang ni kita boleh nampak. Dekat sini kita ada h. Okay, so here we have h. These terms also have h. This term also we have h. So we can factor out. Okay. Okay, so dalam mengira limit. Okay, so we have limit h approaches to 0. H outside. So we have 4x plus 2h minus 1 over. And we can simplify h with h. So it is equal to limit h 0 4x plus 2h minus 1 over 1. Okay, start over lah. Okay. Minus 1. Okay, so it is equal to 4x. So substitute h. So we have 2 times 0 minus 1. So we have 4x plus 2 times 0, 0 minus 1. So ni adalah jawapan dia. Okay, so panjang, memang panjang. Okay. Okay, so kalau soalan minta definition of derivative ni, using the definition of derivative memang panjang. So jangan main skip-skip, okay? So exercise sebelum ni saya bagi tu yang kira limit, banyak yang skip-skip. Okay? Banyak skip step. Sedangkan step-step kat situ tu kita ada markah. Tapi kalau tak ada step tu, macam mana kita nak bagi markah? Okay? So penghabisannya kurang yang tak dapat markah. Contoh macam 0 over 0. Okay. So kena tunjukkan dulu dapat 0 per 0. Okay. So kalau macam ni, actually yang atas ni. So kalau masukkan h, kita dapat 0 per 0. Tapi sebenarnya kita boleh, sebelum kita masuk tu, kat sini kita nampak boleh simplify. Keluarkan h, simplify dengan yang bawah. So ni tak ada masalah. Tapi yang kita tak nampak dia boleh simplify, yang tu kita kena buat 0 per 0. Kena tulis. Okay. Contoh. Okay, contoh limit x approaches to 0. Ada tak contoh? Tak ingatlah, saya nak kena tengok soalan baru boleh dapat contoh. Tengok contoh yang ni lah, nanti ada lah kat bawah-bawah ni. Yes, yang penting ni 0 over 0 and then infinity over infinity. Okay, so infinity over infinity. Kena tunjuk dulu dapat 2 ni, baru buat seterusnya. Macam infinity over infinity ni, apa yang kita kena buat? 0 over 0, apa yang kita kena buat? Okay. So 0 over 0, conjugate. Okay, conjugate. Okay, so conjugate lagi, simplify. Okay, so bila infinity over infinity, divide highest power of x on denominator. And then lagi satu, gunakan apa? yang ni. So square root x square. Okay. And then apa lagi? Square root of x power of 4 dan seterusnya. Okay. So lagi satu, step-step tu kena tunjuk lah. So macam dalam, kita tahu sin x over x as x approaches to 0, the answer is 1. Tapi bila jalan kira, limit x approaches to 0 sin 5x over x. Contoh macam ni. So korang kena tunjukkan bawah ni jadikan sama. Macam mana nak jadikan sama? Jangan tiba-tiba jadi jawapan dapat 5. Daripada mana? Memang jawapan dia 5, tapi daripada mana? Kena tunjuk cara dia. So kalau tiba-tiba dapat 5, memang jawapan betul, tapi cara dia, sedangkan markah tu ada dekat sini. Sin 5x per x ni darab 5, darab 5. So dapatlah limit x approaches to 0. Okay, so yang 5 ni boleh letak luar ataupun depan sin. So letak boleh sin 5x per 5x. Okay, so yang ni baru dapat 5 darab 1. Jawapan dia 5. So sedangkan markah dia dekat sini. Yang ni darab 5 per 5, darab 5, darab 5 ni. Tapi kalau tak buat ni, macam mana nak bagi markah? So tak ada markah lah, kosong lah jawapan korang ni. Kosong lah markah korang. Okay, so lagi satu, factorize. Sama juga factorize. Contoh, limit x approaches to, saya tak ingat, 16 minus 8. 8, 4. 4x. 4x over 4 minus x. Contoh yang atas ni, keluarkan dulu. Okay, approaches to 4 rasanya. Okay, so keluarkan dulu dia punya 4 atas tu. 4, 4 minus x square. Tak ingat lah approaches berapa. Okay, so 4 minus x. Okay, so baru yang atas ni boleh factorize. Ini tak, tiba-tiba daripada sini jump pergi ke sini. 4, 2 minus x, 2 plus x over, ni bawah ni 2. Ok, so 2 minus x. So tiba-tiba jam macam ni. Macam mana? Ni macam ni saya nak bagi markah kat sini. Tiba-tiba jam kat sini, lepas tu tiba-tiba dapat jawapan. Macam mana tu? So jangan main lompat, lompat. So tolong tunjukkan jalan kira tu. Ok? Okay, so sepatutnya step ada 5, tiba-tiba ada 3 step je dah dapat jawapan. Tu pelik lah kan. Ok, so tolong satu lagi tu, kosong per kosong kena tunjukkan. Ok, kenapa perlu tunjukkan? Contoh macam ni lah. 4 minus x square 2 over 2 plus x. Okay, so contoh nampak, kita nampak atas ni boleh factorize ni. Limit x approaches to 2, 2 minus x and then 2 plus x. 2 plus x. Ni kat sini kita boleh simplify kan. Tapi ni macam ni buang masa lah. Sedangkan bila awak ganti, awak dapat 4 minus 2 power of 2 divided by 2 plus 2. So which is 4 minus 2 squared is 0 over 4. So the answer direct 0. Dan bila nak factorize apa semua, anda banyak jangan kira. Sedangkan jawapan dia terus kosong. Tak ada pun nak buat simplify apa semua. So that's why kena tunjuk dulu kosong per kosong, infinity over infinity. Sebab kadang soalan ni kejam sikit. So tak payah tunjuk kosong per kosong ataupun infinity over infinity dah dapat jawab. Tapi bila nampak macam boleh simplify, terus simplify. So buang masa lah kat situ, okay? Okay, so berbalik pada kita punya differentiation tadi. Okay, so example lagi ni. Okay, so yang tadi tu tak adalah saya membebel, tak adalah saya marah pun, tak marah pun, saya tak kisah sangat pun. Okay, cuma untuk korang je lah, markah untuk korang. Okay. Okay, so example, lagi satu. Find the derivative of y equal to x over 1 minus x by using first principle of differentiation. Okay, so first principle. Yang tadi dia kata apa? By using definition. Okay, so sekarang dia pakai first principle of differentiation. So, first principle of differentiation, this one also is the using the definition of differentiation. So, kita kena pakai definition lah. Okay, so y prime ataupun dy over dx. Okay, so it is equal to f x plus h. Okay, so sebelum tu. Okay, so dekat sini y. So we let f x equal to x over minus x. Okay, kita let dulu. Okay, sebab definition tadi dia pakai f. Tapi kat sini, y. Okay, so therefore, f prime x, it is equal to f x plus h minus f x over h. Okay, so gantikan f x plus h. So, all x substitute with x plus h. So, we have x plus h over 1 minus x plus h. And then minus fx. So fx is just x over 1 minus x. Okay, and then divide by h. A limit. Alah, saya tak tulis limit. H. Alah. Okay, so h approaches to 0. Okay, so this one. So limit h approaches to 0. Okay, so lagi satu. So, perkataan limit h approaches to 0 ni macam ni kena tulis sampailah bila korang dah ganti nilai h. Okay, so, jangan buang. Tiba-tiba hilang. Okay. Okay. So, terusnya. So, kat sini kita ada atas ni ada pecahan. Lepas tu sini ada per. So, macam kita ada 1, 2, ada 3 baris lah. Okay, so, first what we need to do. Simplifykan dia jadi 1 baris je. Jadi 1 baris lah. Jadi 2 baris. Okay, so it is equal to limit h approaches to 0. Okay, so x plus h over 1 over this minus x pen. So minus x minus h minus x over 1 minus x. Okay, and then okay, so this divide. Okay, so yang besar ni. Yang utama daripada asalnya, yang utama dekat sini. Ni. Over h. Okay, so over h. So, maksudnya this over become divide lah. Okay. So, jangan ambil yang ni jadi divide lah. Itu salah. Okay, so tengok yang mana per yang paling utama, yang paling besar. So, yang tu yang akan jadi bahagi. Okay, so divide h. H ni adalah per 1. Okay, so it is equal to limit h approaches to 0. X plus h over 1 minus x minus h minus x over 1 minus x. Okay, so divide become multiplication over h. Okay, so seterusnya biarkan dulu yang ni, yang dekat dalam. So yang dekat dalam ni we have 2 fraction. So 1, 2. Kita ada 2 fraction. Okay, so combine become 1 fraction. So, gabungkan jadi satu pecahan. So, macam mana nak gabungkan? Kita kena samakan pembawah. Ok, Okay, so it is equal to limit h approaches to 0. So x plus h times with 1 minus x, and then minus x times with 1 minus ini 1 minus x minus h. Okay, so over. Okay, so yang bawah kita dah samakan, so jadilah 1 minus x minus h times with 1 minus x. Okay, and then times with 1 over h. Okay, and then simplify yang atas tu. So limit h approaches to 0. Okay, so simplify yang atas ni, so you need to expand x times 1 become x, x times negative x square, positive h times 1, positive h times negative x, so negative x h. Okay, and then minus x times 1, minus x times minus x, plus x square, minus x minus h become plus x h over. Yang bawah tu tak payah expand, biar je 1 minus x minus h, 1 minus x times with 1 over h. Okay, so after that simplify yang atas tu. Okay, so it is equal to limit h approaches to 0. Okay, so x minus x, okay, become 0. And then minus x square plus x square cancel. And then plus h. Okay, so tak ada lagi h yang lain, so just h. Okay, so plus h, h lah. Okay, then minus xh plus xh. Okay, so 0. Okay, so tinggal h sahaja. Over 1 minus x minus h, 1 minus x times with 1 over h. Okay, so darab dekat sini. So ni pecahan, sini pecahan. Ni kat atas, yang ni kat bawah. So yang atas dengan bawah, kalau sama kita boleh permudahkan. So simplify this one. Okay, so jangan simplify dengan h. Kat sini tolak h, 1 minus x minus h. Okay, so tolak h, h ni hanya x ni. Okay, macam ni darab semua ni. So kita boleh simplify atas dengan bawah. Okay, so we have limit h approaches to 0. Okay, so dah simplify tinggal satu lah. 1 over 1 minus x minus h, 1 minus x. Then substitute h. Okay, so it is equal to 1 over 1 minus x minus 0, 1 minus x. Okay, so nampak dah substitute h, limit, perkataan limit tu hilang lah. Okay, so it is equal to 1 over 1 minus x times with 1 minus x. So the answer is 1 over 1 minus x power of 2. Okay, so dapatlah jawapan dia. Okay, so lagi satu pasal permudahan. Contoh macam y ni yang biasa orang buat salah ni. So y is equal to x over 1 minus x. So dia boleh dipotong ni dengan ni. So tinggallah 1. Okay, so ni salah. Ni tak boleh potong sebab yang tolak x ni 1. Okay, so lain kalau korang ada x per 1 tolak x, darab, darab 1 per x. Ni baru boleh permudahkan, satu ke atas, satu ke bawah. Okay. Oh, lagi satu, square root. Ni pun salah ni. Kalau square root x plus 3, so jangan pecahkan square root x tambah square root 3. Ni salah, okay. So ni salah, okay. So ada yang buat ni nanti. So ni tak boleh pecahkan macam ni, okay, salah. Okay, so ni saya explain beberapa kesalahan lah yang dibuat. Okay, Okay, so balik pada derivatif tadi. Okay, so another example. So find f of fx equal to square root 2x minus 2 by using first principle of differentiation. So kita kena guna limit. Okay, so f prime x, it is equal to limit h approaches to 0 f x plus h minus f x over h. So it is equal to limit h approaches to 0. So substitute x with x plus h. So we have square root 2 x plus h minus 2 and then minus fx. So fx square root 2x minus 2 over h. Okay, so simplify yang dalam ni dulu, kembangkan. So we have limit h approaches to 0 square root 2x plus 2h minus 2 minus square root 2x minus 2 over h. Okay, so seterusnya nak buat apa ni? Macam mana? Okay, so ni kalau korang substitute h, so what will happen? So you'll have square root 2x plus 2 times 0, 0 minus 2 minus square root 2x minus 2 over 0. So what you will have here, square root 2x minus 2 minus square root 2x minus 2 over 2. Okay, so ni square root 2x minus 2 minus square root 2x minus 2. So bila kita tolakkan dua benda yang sama, so dia akan jadi kosong. So this one become 0 over 0. So bila dapat 0 over 0, so apa yang kita kena buat? Darab dengan conjugate. Okay, so darab dengan conjugate. Okay, tunjuk dulu kosong per kosong. Okay, so baru kita buat darab dengan conjugate. Sepanjang jalan kira, memanglah panjang. Memang panjang jalan kira dia. Nak buat macam mana? Okay, so step dia macam tu. Okay, so limit h approaches to 0 square root of 2x plus 2h minus 2 minus square root of 2x minus 2 over h. Okay, so darab dengan conjugate. Okay, so conjugate that adalah square root 2x plus 2h minus 2. So this minus become positive, become plus. Okay, so square root of 2x minus 2. Okay, so bila atas darab conjugate, so bawah pun sama. Okay, okay, so darabkan dengan conjugate. Okay, so kalau siapa yang dah biasa buat conjugate ni, so dia akan tahu. So jawapan dia tinggal yang ni, darab ni. So we have 2x plus 2h, dan negatif, positif, negatif. Yang ni, darabkan dengan yang ni, 2x minus 2. Sebab nanti yang tengah-tengah tu hilang. Okay, so kalau siapa yang biasa buat, dia tahulah. Okay, so yang bawah ni kita dapat h. Okay, so yang bawah h in bracket square root 2x plus 2h minus 2 plus square root 2x minus 2. Okay, and then you have here, equal to limit h approaches to 0, so 2x plus 2h minus 2, so negative expand, so you will have minus 2x plus 2 over h square root of 2x plus 2h minus 2 plus square root 2x minus 2. Okay, so you will have here limit h approaches to 0, So 2x minus 2x, 0. 2h, okay, so 2h minus 2 plus 2, 0. Okay, cuma 2h ni, 2h sahajalah. Okay, so 2h over h square root of 2x plus 2h minus plus square root 2x minus 2. Okay, so h cancel. So we have limit h approaches to 0, 1 over 1 pula, 2 lah. Okay, so 2 over square root 2x plus 2h minus 2 plus square root 2x minus 2. Okay, so it is equal to, so substitute h, so we have 2 over square root 2x plus 0 minus 2 plus square root 2x minus 2. Okay, so we have here 2 over square root 2x minus 2 plus square root 2x minus 2. Okay, so bila kita tambahkan dua benda yang sama, so dia jadi 2 over 2 square root 2x minus 2. Okay, so 2 and 2 we can cancel. So we have 1 over square root 2x minus 2. Okay, so dapatlah jawapan dia. Okay, okay, so next, ada lagi example. Okay, so given that y equal to square root x plus 3, find divide over dx using the first principle of differentiation. Okay, so ni function dia y. So let f x equal to square root x plus 3. Okay, so f prime x, it is equal to f x plus h minus by f x over h. Alah, limit lupa tulis. So limit h approaches to 0, f x plus h f x over h. Okay, so it is equal to limit h approaches to 0, so substitute x with x plus h. So we have square root x plus h plus 3, then minus fx, so square root x plus 3 over h. So we have here limit h approaches to 0. Okay, so square root x plus h plus 3, so expand negative, so negative square root x minus 3 over h. Okay, so 3 minus 3 become 0. Okay, so this one positive 3 minus 3. Okay, so 0. So it is equal to it. H approaches to 0. Square root x plus h minus square root x over h. Okay, so ada lagi boleh simplify? Tak ada. Okay, so gantikan h. So you will have square root x plus 0 minus square root x over 0. So it is equal to, okay, so square root x plus 0, square root x lah. Okay, so square root x minus square root x, 0 over 0. So dapat kosong per kosong, kita kena darabkan dengan conjugate. Okay, so square root x plus h minus square root x over h times with square root x plus h, so this minus become plus. Okay, so yang atas darab tu, bawah pun kena darab benda yang sama. Okay, so the answer is limit h approaches to 0. Okay, so square root x plus h times square root x plus h, so we have x plus h, then minus square root x times with plus square root x become minus x over h square root. Okay, so square root of x plus h plus square root x. Okay, Hilang pula ke mana. Okay, so tadi darab conjugate kita dapat limit h approaches to 0. X plus h minus x over h square root x plus h plus square root x. Okay, so dapat yang ni. Okay, so sama dengan, so limit h approaches to 0, so x minus x 0, so we have h over h square root x plus h plus square root x. Okay, so h with h we can cancel. Okay, so the only left is limit h approaches to 0, 1 over square root x plus h plus square root x. So it is equal to 1 over square root x plus 0 plus square root x. Okay, so the answer is 1 over square root x plus square root x. So 2 square root x. Okay. Okay. Okay, so next we go to the technique of differentiation. Okay, so ni cara yang kedua lah. So cara yang kedua ni dia senang lah. So if we differentiate nombor, kalau constant ni kita differentiate, dia akan dapat kosong. Ini ax plus b, so the answer is x. Power is xn. So if the function is x power of n, so the differentiation of xn is n kita buat depan, and then x power of n minus 1. Okay. So konsep dia kuasa buat ke depan, lepas tu kuasa dia kita tolak 1. Okay, so kalau korang nak hafal, hafal bawah ni pun dah cukup. Sebab yang atas tu linear. Contoh yang linear tu, katakan saya ada fx sama dengan 2x tambah b. So x ni kuasa 1. Okay, so x ni kuasa dia 1. Okay, so bila korang gunakan konsep yang bawah tu, f prime x, so 1 buat depan, darabkan dengan 2, x kuasa dia tolak lagi 1, 1 tolak 1, tambah b pula, tambah 3 lah. So tambah 3. Okay, so constant yang belakang, kita differentiate constant, dia akan jadi kosong. So plus 0. So it is equal to 1 times by 2, 2, so 2 x power of 0. So x power of 0, jawapan dia, so jawapan dia adalah 1 lah. So x kuasa kosong ni jawapan dia 1, so jawapan dia 2. Okay, so yang ni saya salah ni. Okay, so ax plus b, so the answer should be a. Okay, so saya salah type. Okay, so jawapan dia adalah a. Okay. So dia guna konsep yang bawah ni, sama je. So kalau constant tu pun sama. So let's say fx is equal to 8. Okay, so 8 actually 8 times by 1. So this one actually you can write down as x power of 0. Okay, so kenapa saya nak tulis x? Sebab function of x lah. Sebab nak differentiate respect to x. Okay, so saya boleh keluarkan x kuasa kosong. Okay, so therefore f prime x, it is equal to, so 0 bawa di depan, 0 times with 8 x 0 minus 1. And then since 0, so 0 times with anything, so the answer is 0 lah. Okay, sebab tu kita differentiatekan nombor, dia jadi kosong. Kalau differentiatekan linear ni, ax plus b, so dia dapat a. Kalau power, x power of n, so kuasa buat depan, and then x kuasa dia kita tolak dengan 1. Okay, so example. Okay, so differentiate each of doing with respect to x. Okay, so contoh yang a, so fx equal to 8, so therefore f prime x is equal to 0. So constant kalau kita differentiate dapat kosong. So yang b, f prime x is equal to Okay, so linear. So dia dapat constant lah, 3. And then C, F prime X. So it is equal to, so power buat depan. Okay, so 2 times with 2 power of 2X power of 2 minus 1. Okay, so rasa dia tolak 1. So we have 2 times by 2, 4. And then X power of 2 minus 1 become 1. So 4X lah. Okay. And then D, okay, so D tak ada kuasa, so macam mana? So berbalik pada hukum indeks dulu. So kalau square root, kuasa dia adalah power of 1 over 2. Okay, so power bring in front fx. So f prime x, it is equal to 1 over 2 times with x power of 1 over 2 minus 1. Okay, so 1 over 2. 1 over 2 minus 1. So the answer is negative 1 over 2. Okay. So from law of the indices, so we have 1 over 2. So bila ada kuasa negatif, so dia akan jadi 1 over x power of 1 over 2. So the answer is 1 over 2 square root x. Okay. Hilang pula. Okay, so korang dah salin kan? Okay, so contoh lain, E pun samalah. Fx equal to cube root of x. Okay, so cube root of x, this one is x power of 1 over 3. So f prime x, so the answer is 1 over 3. And then x power of 1 over 3 minus 1. So we have 1 over 3. 1 over 3 minus 1, so we have negative 2 over 3. Okay, so the law of indices, if you have negative, so become 1 over x power of 2 over 3. So the answer is 1 over 3x power of 2 over 3. And then F. Okay, so F we have 1 over x. So 1 over x actually is x power of negative 1. So therefore F prime x, the answer is, so negative 1 bawa ke depan. So negative 1 x power of negative 1 minus 1. So the answer is negative 1 x power of negative 2. So it is equal to negative 1 x power of negative 2 is 1 over x square. So the answer is negative 1 over x square. Okay. Then G, G ni kita ada tolak, ada tambah. Macam mana sir? So bila ada macam tu, kita buat 1 per 1. So F prime X, it is equal to cube. So we have 3 X power of 3 minus 1. Okay, and then minus. Okay, so kuasa 2, 2 buat depan. So 2x power of 2 minus 1 plus, okay, so ni x power of 1. So 1 bring in front. So x power of 1 minus 1. So the answer is 3x power of 2 minus 4x plus x power of 0 is 1 lah, so 1. Okay, so ni jawapan dia. Okay, so yang ni konsep dia, konsep yang ni lah. Okay, so derivative, sums and difference. Okay, so let fx and gx be a differentiable function. Then derivative of fx plus gx, so we differentiate each of them. Okay, so kita differentiate fx and then plus differentiate gx. Okay, so same for minus. So if minus pun samalah. Okay, so differentiate f and then minus differentiate g. So ni kat sini kita ada contoh lagi ni. Okay, so differentiate the following with respect to x. sama lah. So y prime or dy over dx is equal to 6, bring in front times with 2. So you will have 12 x power of 5 minus 34 plus x power of 2 plus 2x minus 0. Okay, so yang benda ni congak, so orang boleh je terus kira macam ni, tak payah tunjuk jalan kira pun tak apa, okay? And then b f prime x, it is equal to so macam ni kita ada cube root ni, tunjuklah sikit sebab saya cube root ni bahaya nak congak. Okay, so nanti dia akan jadi careless nanti. 1 over 3. Okay, so power of 1 over 3 minus, so ada yang kat bawah ni, so 5x power of negative 2 plus x minus 5. Ni fx. Okay, so f prime x, so it is equal to 3 times 3, 9x square plus 1 over 3 x power of 1 over 3 minus 1 negative 2 over 3, and then negative 5 times negative 2, positive 10, power of x power of negative 2 minus 1, negative 3, and then x become 1 lah. Okay, so constant become 0. Okay, so then the answer is 9 plus 1 over 3 times with 1 over x power of 2 over 3 plus 10 times 1 over x power of 3 plus 1. Okay, so yang power negatif tu ni turun ke bawah lah, jadi 1 over. So equal to 9x power of 2 plus 1 over 3x power of 2 over 3 plus 10 over x power of 3 plus 1. And then C, macam mana C ni? Okay, so C ni sama lah. Okay, so ni kat sini kita ada darab, tapi yang tadi kita ada konsep tu tambah dengan tolak je. So bila darab, kena kembangkan. Okay, so kembangkan dulu. So you will have square root x times x power of 2 plus 2 square root x. So square root x darab, okay. So square root x is x power of 1 over 2 times x power of 2 plus 2x power of 1 over 2. Okay, so darab, pemboleh ubah dia sama, xx. Okay, so hukum indeks kita boleh tambahkan kuasa. So this one is x power of 5 over 2 plus 2x power of 1 over 2, and then differentiate. So differentiate, we have f prime x, so which is equal to 5 over 2 x 5 over 2 minus 1 berapa lah, nanti kita, okay. So tambah 2 times 1 over 2 x 1 over 2 minus 1. Okay, so we have here 5 over 2 x power of 5 over 2 minus 1 is 3 over 2. Okay, so 3 over 2 plus 2 times by 1 over 2 become 1 lah. Okay, so this one is x power of 1 over 2 minus 1, negative 1 over 2. So the answer is 5 over 2 x power of 3 over 2 plus 1 over square root x. Okay. Okay, so another example we have here. So another ada pecahan pula. Tadi atas darab, ni bahagi. So darab bahagi tu, kang nanti dia ada cara lain lah sebenarnya. Ada second alternative. Okay. So yang D ni. Okay, so alternative yang pertama kita boleh buat 2x power of 5 over x minus x power of 2 over x minus 1 over x. Okay, so this one is 2x power of 4 minus x minus x power of negative 1. So ni baru simplify. And then find f prime x. So f prime x, it is equal to 4 times by 2, 8x power of 3, minus 1, so negative, times negative 1, positive, x power of negative 1 minus 1, negative 2. So it is equal to 8x power of 3, minus 1, plus 1 over x square. Okay, so yang e itu kena expand pula, okay? So e, fx, it is equal to x square, plus 4x plus 4. Okay, so f prime x, so we have 2x. Okay, so 2 buat depan, and then 2 tolak 1 tinggal 1, plus differentiate for x, 4. Differentiate constant, 0. So ni jawapan dia, okay? Okay, so actually yang C ni ni darab, D ni bahagi, E ni ada kuasa. Okay, so kurungan dalam dia ada, lepas tu ada kuasa. So ni ada lagi, ada second alternative nanti. Okay, so nanti kita akan belajar. Okay, kita berkaitan dengan product rule. So product rule dengan quotient rule. Okay. Okay, dah nak habis. Okay, so habiskan lah. Okay, so product rule lah. So product rule, if you have y equal to uv, where u and v be a differentiable function, so then the derivative of y is equal to u times derivative of v plus v derivative of u, or divide over dx equal to uv prime plus vu prime. So contohnya ni, so fx equal to this one. Okay, so ni kita ada darab kat sini. So ada dua function, u, v. So therefore f prime x is equal to u x3 minus 1 times with v prime. So with v prime, kita differentiate lah v prime tu. So 3 kali 2, 6, x plus 1, then plus v x square plus x times with u prime, 3x square, then expand. Okay, so lagi satu, kalau siapa yang tak ada, tak mahir nak congak macam ni, kita buatlah dulu. Cari u, cari u prime. Okay, so u is equal to x cube minus 1, so u prime is equal to 3x square, and then v equal to 3x plus x, and v prime is equal to 6x plus 1. Okay, so therefore f prime x, it is equal to uv prime, so x cube minus 1 times with 6x plus 1, and plus vu prime, 3x square plus x, so u prime is 3x square, and then expand, x cube 6x, 6x power of 4, x cube times 1 plus x cube minus 1 times 6x minus 6x minus 1 times positive 1 minus 1. So yang ni pun samalah, okay? So we have 9x power of 4 plus 3x power of 3. Okay, so yang kuasa 4, 6x, 9, 15. Kuasa 3, so x cube plus 3x cube, so plus 4x cube, then minus 6x minus 1. So dapatlah jawapan dia. Okay, so ada example pun samalah ni. Okay, soal u x power of 5. Okay, so u prime is equal to 5x power of 4. V is equal to 2x power of 4 x power of 2. So v prime is equal to 8x cube minus 2x. Okay, so then f prime x, it is equal to uv prime x power of 5, 8x power of 3 minus 2x plus vu prime, 2x power of 4 minus x power of 2 times with 5x power of 4. So it is equal to expand 8x 3 5 8 minus 2x x times x 5 become x power of 6 plus, so this one 2x power of 4 times 5x power of 4 become 10x power of 8 negative x squared times 5x power of 4, so negative 5x power of 6. Okay, so the answer we have here 8 plus 10 18x power of 8 minus 2x power of 6 minus 5x power of 6, so minus 7x power of 6. Okay, and then the last one is quotient rule. Okay, so quotient rule, bahagilah if y equal to u over v, so where u and v be a differentiable function, so then dy over dx is equal to v differentiate of u minus u differentiate of v over v power of 2. Ataupun yang lagi mudah, v u prime minus u v prime over v power of 2. So example kat sini. Okay, so buat dulu u. Okay, so u is equal to 1 minus 2x. So u prime is equal to negative 2. V is equal to x plus 3. So v prime is equal to 1. Okay, so dy over dx. Okay, so yang ni bahagi kita start dengan v dulu. Kalau tadi darab, kita start dengan u. Okay, so start dengan v. X plus 3 times with u prime. Negative 2. And then minus. Okay, so kalau bahagi dia tolak. Kalau darab tadi jadi tambah. So dia ada synchronize sikit lah, macam index dulu. Bahagi jadi tolak, darab jadi tambah. Okay. And then u. 1 minus 2x times v prime. V prime 1 over v square. So v square x plus 3 power of 2. And then simplify yang atas ni. So we have negative 2x minus 6. Okay, so ni 1 ni, tak apalah, kita boleh bagikan sebab dia 1. So 1 dah dapat apa-apa, dia dapat benda tu jugalah. Then expand this negative. So we have negative 1 plus 2x. So yang bawah tu tak payah expand pun tak apa. Okay, so the answer is negative 2x plus 2x 0. So negative 6 minus 1 is negative 7. So negative 7 over x plus 3 power of 2. Okay. Okay, so that's all for our lesson today. So see you later. Thank you and assalamualaikum.